And good morning, everyone. Welcome to This Day.
Good morning. Today is Wednesday, and it's January 15th, and as Ken is showing us, it is National Hat Day.
It is.
Yay. I mean, I was a dope and forgot my hat, but here, I've got this one.
I've got this one.
This is the best one, Laguna Woods Village. Okay, so who's on our show today?
On our show today, we're going to bring you a segment with Kaiser Permanente of Orange County. And who was the, I'm sorry, because this was a... I interviewed them yesterday, the doctor, and I forgot what his special, what her specialty was.
Well, but you'll just have to wait
and find out. And also, but you know, Kaiser's opening a new place up near my house, up in Foothill Ranch, where we live. That'll be great. All right, and Body Flux Sport, they were on once a little bit of time ago, and we got a couple guests, and they're going to talk about their wonderful, I guess it's called, it's not a treadmill, I guess it's sort of, I don't know what I would call it, but... it's a great apparatus to get exercise. It's just wonderful because I tried it last time and really had a good time with it. Also, we're from the Senior Center. They're CEO of AgeWell. We're going to have a Steve Moyer on, and he's going to talk about what's going on with them. And also for the Democratic Club, Alan Feldman is coming on now. Alan is going to talk about their upcoming meeting, and they're going to have some of the candidates running for different offices that are part of the Democratic Party. So he'll tell us all about that.
All right, and our meetings today, we have the village traffic hearings. We've got the morning ones, which will be in the boardroom at 9 a.m. And then we have the afternoon ones, which will be in the Sycamore Room at 1 p.m. Then we have the third resident policy and compliance task force meeting, and that will be in the boardroom at 1:30 this afternoon. All right, we'll dig out your favorite hat and tell the story behind it if somebody asks you. Wear your warmest toque or stocking cap beanie and share the name you give it. There are so many hats, fashions, and names, and certainly we could wear a hat every day and never get through them all. Hats may be worn for safety and protection, religious reasons, ceremonial reasons, warmth, or fashion. In the Middle Ages, hats were an indicator of social status. A Thebes tomb painting depicts one of the first pictorials of a hat, and that's the painting shows a man wearing a comical straw hat, as you see here on the left. Structured hats for women began to be worn in the late 16th century, and a lot went into those hats. It's called millinery. It is the designing and manufacturing of hats. The term milliner derived from the city of Milan, Italy. The best quality hats were made in Milan in the 18th century. However, when you take a look at the photo in the middle, that is obviously England, and that is the, well, gosh, she's not the queen, but she's ready to be the queen, that's for sure. Millinery began as a traditional women's occupation, but as the milliner not only created hats and bonnets, but also trim and accessories to complete an outfit. So there you go. So dig out your hats and have a good hat day.
Yes, that was what Lady Middleton wearing a fascinator.
Kate Middleton, yes. Yes, she was.
That's what they're called.
You,
I don't know where the name comes from, but I remember learning about that from Sheila Bialka.
That's right.
So
she told me about that.
I heard that term and she told me all about it. All right, let's talk about the weather coming up. Not as much clouds today, right yet. We're going to see increasing clouds coming on a little bit later. And the rain, it's shifting around once again, and the window is getting smaller. So what we're going to start to see tomorrow, we could have a little spotty rain a little bit during the day, but mostly what it's looking right now, first the temperature, you can see had dropped quite a bit, but we're looking at rain probably hitting this area sometime after, it could maybe not even till 10 o'clock, and that window of where we're going to get the heaviest rain, it doesn't mean it's going to be that heavy, but the biggest window there is going to be from about 10 o'clock at night to about 2 or 3 in the morning. And then after that, it'll mostly go away, and we were at first going to look at rain coming in on Friday, but now it looks like it's not going to be here at all. Going forward, you can see the temperature rises, and we're just going to have a nice, nice string of weather starting around Sunday, and that 70-degree mark will be with us for probably 2 or 3 days. That's kind of what I'm thinking. Now, let's take a look at around the area around Orange County and beyond. Temperatures are pretty much similar to what we had yesterday. I think they're down by a couple degrees here and there, but then they're up north in some areas. North Orange County is up a little bit. San Diego's up. So, but you know, not much difference from what we had yesterday. Overall, It's actually going to be pretty darn nice. And, you know, tomorrow about the rain when we get it, I'm thinking maybe if we're lucky, we'll get a half inch of rain. So that would be nice. We need this, right? So, you know, at this time of the year, every couple of weeks, we should be getting a little bit of rain and then a little bit more as we get into February and March to keep that amount that we need up. All right, we'll be back in just a moment.
Vince Ferragamo. I spent some of my best years as an NFL quarterback, but today I've got a new team, and we're helping seniors who spent their best years fighting for our country, defending our freedom, and informing the nation. Our hometown heroes need help. AgeWell Senior Services is their lifeline. Nonprofit AgeWell can do all of this because you care enough to give. Please join me in supporting AgeWell. Donate today.
Jacobson McCall have created Agent 55, a real estate firm focused on 55-plus communities.
Agent 55 and the marketing technology allows us to deliver even more to buyers and sellers.
Everyone respects Kelly's over 30 years' experience as a top sales producer and trusted expert within 55-plus communities.
Agent 55 has great knowledge of Laguna Woods.
Agent 55 offers something powerful and unique. We guarantee it. Ask us how.
Welcome back, but we have Lori Viveros, who is here from Kaiser Permanente, and we're going to talk about life care planning. And welcome to the show. Nice to have
you
on.
Thank you.
And we were talking a little bit beforehand that, you know, life care planning can be difficult at any age, but you guys are actually trying to go a little younger. So before we get into that, tell me a little bit about yourself and how long you've been with Kaiser Permanente.
Sure. Well, I've been with Kaiser Permanente for 5 years, and I'm the regional director for life care planning. Mm-hmm. Really gives me an opportunity to look at ways that Kaiser Permanente can engage in conversations about what's important, about what it is that we value, that helps us inform future healthcare decisions. And so it's a remarkable initiative and effort that we're able to be a part of and lead in Southern California.
Okay, well, excellent. Well, let's talk a little bit about, you know, life care planning. What exactly is that?
Life care planning is the way Kaiser Permanente does advanced care planning and serious illness management. Mm-hmm. We have an approach in which we engage in these important conversations as early as 18 years of age, mm-hmm. and really start to think about what it is important to us, what is it that we value, and who's going to be your spokesperson in the event that you come across a situation where you can't speak for yourself, and that person needs to inform the care team about what you would want and not want.
Right.
In particular situations.
Well,
yeah.
At what point, though, would Kaiser Permanente be a part of that? So, for instance, is it something mm-hmm. that a doctor would speak to the patient about, like, hey, have you thought about this? Or how do you actually interject?
Yeah, it's a great question. Absolutely. So we see it as a team sport. So whether I'm coming in for a physical exam or I'm coming in to have an exam done, a mammogram, for instance, mm-hmm. We believe that it should be part of the care experience that every member has. Mm-hmm. So just as normal place as a flu shot or a blood pressure check, having that engagement by a nurse, you know, as I'm getting checked in, continuing that conversation with a physician mm-hmm. who tells me about how important it is and the value that it brings to my life and to my family's lives. Mm-hmm. And then if I need additional support or assistance, maybe a social worker or a chaplain might get involved in that conversation. So we really see this as connecting all the dots as a member goes through the care experience with Kaiser Permanente.
Okay, so it's just one of the many things that you guys do.
Exactly.
Like you said, upon check-in or something like that, do you just mm-hmm. say, well, have you thought about life care planning?
Exactly,
okay.
exactly,
right,
yeah.
So I know we talked about being difficult. I mean, at the age of 18, I was mentioning that, you know, I had a family member in my my life. It was the age of 16, and I really didn't want to talk about it because I felt like it was a very morbid discussion. So how do you help 18-year-olds realize that it's something that they should be considering?
That's great. So we really want to anchor it as part of wellness. We want to normalize this process, that this is something that's for all adults. Everyone should be thinking about, because we don't have a crystal ball. We don't know what's going to happen. So let's equip our family members, our loved ones, our friends with how can we be put in that position. If I had to speak on behalf of my loved one, what is it that I would want them to say? What is it that you know, I value? What does quality of life mean to me? So that we can make informed decisions down the road.
Right.
You know, and I think that it is something that while we want to start it young, we also want to continue the conversation. So it's going to iterate. It's going to evolve as we age and we experience life. So if, for instance, I've done my life care planning and I've talked to my husband about what it is that I want. Okay. I've also had conversations with my family members, my brothers, my sister about that, so that they can support my husband if we're put in that situation.
Okay.
And now let's say I had a well-managed chronic condition for some time. It's starting to advance. I'm starting to experience maybe a decline in my health. That conversation is going to evolve, where I'm having conversations with my care team about, again, what is it that I value, what's important to me, and how does that inform evidence-based treatment decisions that I'm currently needing to make.
Okay.
And as I age and I, you know, maybe decline in that condition, I am now in the last year or two of my life, I'm again having that conversation about what it is that I value now, what's important to me, and how do we marry that with life-sustaining treatment such as CPR.
Okay.
In my last couple of years of life.
Okay.
And so when we start the conversation early, we're really laying down that foundation so that when we have that conversation again, as life changes, my preferences, my values will evolve and change as well. It's meant to be an ongoing conversation.
Some statistics that you had identified is 37% of Americans have completed some form of an advance directive. So would it be what you're discussing is actually reaching out to family members? And is that the type of advanced type of what you're talking about? Or are they already filled out a DNR and things like that?
Yeah, so an advance directive is the document that we use to capture the preferences and the values of our members.
Okay.
It's a legal document that allows you to designate a person who would speak on your behalf.
Okay.
And then document what those preferences and wishes might be. So when we hear that 37% of folks have something in place, at Kaiser Permanente, we want to make sure that it's not just about the document, having a document in place, but have we had the conversation?
Okay.
Have we layered on that quality piece so that we really truly understand what is that member's story? What is it that makes them them, so that we can then, as a health system, honor those wishes?
Okay.
So that's an important piece to our program.
Okay, so you actually offer life care planning at all of your facilities. So tell me about what that would cover.
Yes, absolutely. So we have various tools that members could access in order to start their life care plan, one of which are workshops.
Okay.
So we offer workshops in Orange County, specifically Mission Viejo, Irvine, Anaheim, La Habra. So folks can come to those workshops. They can bring the individual that they're thinking about selecting as a healthcare decision maker for them, so they can be informed and learn more about the process. We also have an online option as well, so kp.org/lifecareplan, that you can do in the comfort of your own home, start that process. And then we have one-on-one facilitator appointments and services, so that if you need more support, you can work one-on-one with somebody that can guide you through the process itself.
That's great. And the fact that you have an individual, or that you even have something online, you know, it's a good guide to sort of get you started.
Right, exactly.
Excellent.
Exactly.
Okay, so good. So you mentioned that the workshops are all over Southern Orange County, and also at the hospitals as well.
Right, exactly.
Right, okay.
Exactly.
And then tell me again, how can they find out more about the workshops?
So they can call the 188 number.
Oh yeah, that was up there too.
On the screen, that to register and find out when those classes are going to be held, and make sure that they get registered for them.
Okay, and that was 888-988 2800, mm-hmm. or they could go to your website, which was kp.org/lifecareplan.
Correct. Yes.
Thank you so much for shedding light on this. I think that's really important. Oh,
thank you, Lisa, for the opportunity. This is great.
All right. And remember, if you want more information about what we just discussed, life care planning, you can always go to their website. And that was kp.org/lifecareplan. We'll be right back.
Hey, Laguna Woods, it's Ken.
And Lisa.
Did you miss an episode of This Day? Not to worry. Head over to youtube.com and search Village Television.
Here you can find each episode of This Day and other community programs such as Good Day OC, Discovering Laguna Woods, and much more.
Just click the red subscribe button, then click the bell to be emailed every time we upload a video.
Don't miss out.
And subscribe today.
Hi, I'm Ann Mundell Noel, audiologist and owner of Amazing Hearing. As an audiologist, I have the education and expertise to assess, diagnose, and treat hearing loss. Hearing aids are only one part of the treatment process. The way we have been taught to fit, counsel, and use hearing therapy is what makes us different. Amazing Hearing, audiologists with the education, expertise, and empathy to change how you hear.
Welcome back. We have Body Flex Sports here today, and with us is Yvonne and John, and they have some great information, especially about this lovely item right here, which is small and compact and can fit in your home. Well, welcome both of you. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you, Lisa.
So John, you haven't been on with us before, so tell us just a little bit about yourself.
I am a virgin here on TV with you guys. I've been working with Body Flex Sports for about 12 to 13 years.
Okay.
Vice President of Sales, and I've known Yvonne's dad, Bob, who started the company, I believe, almost 30 years ago. And I know him for about 30 years.
Okay, great.
So we just got together about 12, 13 years ago, and we started working together, and here I am.
Now, before we went on, we were talking a little bit about moving, and your parents lived here, and they were moving all the time. 2 miles a day they were walking, and they were how old, 90?
In their 90s,
right.
Yes.
Right.
And one of the things that's so important as we get older, I am a senior citizen, so I know, sometimes in the morning things start hearing noises, and they're actually my knees and my ankles and my elbows creaking. But the most important thing to do is to move.
Right.
And there's kind of an acronym for move. The M, you need to be motivated.
Mm-hmm.
Whether it's your spouse, your friends, or yourself, you need to be motivated to do something that day.
Right.
The O is for oxygenate. The way our body heals, the body is a remarkable machine. The most remarkable machine. The way to heal itself is for blood flow. It goes into all of our joints. It heals our sorenesses. And the way the blood flow heals us is through oxygen. The V is for variety. Do lots of things.
Mm-hmm.
A simple walk or a machine that allows you to do a variety of things.
Right.
1, 2, 3 different types of exercises.
Right.
And the E, just be energized. Mm-hmm. Be excited about waking up that day and do something.
Right.
Make it a goal to say, I'm gonna do something today. Doesn't matter what it is, just mm-hmm. do something. So think of the word move.
Mm-hmm.
That'll get you started in your exercise program.
Oh, perfect. Perfect. All right. Well, speaking about moving, tell us a little bit about what we're looking at here and why Body Flex is one of the most important places to go to for this type of equipment.
Yeah. Thanks, Lisa. So what we have here is the BST800, our Body Power Step Track. And we wanted to make something that was compact, efficient, and mostly safe
there are a lot of companies and a lot of fitness products out there that might still add some stress to the knees, the joints, the body. Mm-hmm. We wanted to create something that was really fluid, something that felt good and natural when you rode on it. And one of the fun things that we were talking about is this patented curve crank.
Okay.
And you'll see this neat little curve design here. We actually spent 7 years in the United States Patent and Trademark Office process mm-hmm. to get this feature patented.
Wow.
And it allows the rider, the user on our exercise product, get a smooth, fluid motion as they're working out.
Okay.
So it's ergonomic, it's biomechanically safe, and you're getting a great workout without stressing the body anymore. You're really doing good for the body.
So is it because of the shape of it or because of what it's made of?
Such a great question. So it's the shape. Part of it is the geometry of it.
Okay.
And so there's a sort of flow with angles and a way that it allows the body to continuously move. Mm-hmm. Whereas you might see on other fitness products a straight crank. Mm-hmm. And the straight crank, it actually forms what we call a dead spot or a dead angle. So you might feel this sort of jerking feeling. And John, I think you might be able to talk a little bit more about that.
Yeah, well, I'll demonstrate on the machine.
Thank you.
A lot of, and the learning curve on this machine is about half a second.
Sure, I mean, you just got right on.
You just get right on it, and you can use it with both handles.
Right.
Moving
yes.
upper mm-hmm. body as well as lower body.
Right.
Or if you just, you know what, I don't feel safe doing it that way. I just mm-hmm. want to have something stable. You
right.
just use it with this. Now, yeah.
And we can see down here the way it's moving
yes.
and the way you're moving is there is no dead spot. It
there's,
is fluid.
There's no, when you get on an elliptical, you know, sometimes you hit and you feel like you're kind of falling down.
Right. Mm-hmm.
This removes that.
Okay. All right, and then, so you have a choice here, and then I think there's heart, is there heart monitors on there?
Right here on these okay. handles, it's a heart rate monitor.
Okay.
So if you want to keep yourself within a zone,
right. mm-hmm.
you can just, and you can go slower.
Right.
Or faster.
Right.
Give yourself your workout.
Well, the other thing is it's nice and stable. I know many people in our community are worried about stability and balance.
You basically almost can't tip this thing over.
You pretty much, yeah, that's excellent. It does have wheels. Mm-hmm.
So if you want to move it from one space, you know, you want to vacuum or move it from one room to another, you just pick it up, move it easily.
Okay, excellent. Well, tell me a little bit more about it. Like, what are some of the variety of things that you can do on it?
Well, the evolution of this machine is that in the early 80s to the 90s, the number one machine was a stepper. Mm-hmm. That evolved to the elliptical. Mm-hmm. What this allows you to do is both.
Right.
So it gives you the variety where you want to act like a stepper or act like an elliptical.
Okay.
And you can put yourself in different body positions as well as doing it backwards. Mm-hmm. So you want to work different parts of your leg.
Okay.
Get down and get the squats.
Wow, yeah. You can do all sorts of stuff. And good, you know, and you're holding on, so
you're holding on.
It's not unsafe.
And it's like, oh, I want to get a little upper body workout.
Right, right.
So you got this going.
Right. And I would imagine there's different tensions.
There's different tensions.
Okay.
If you can.
So we can adjust. There are 8 levels of preset magnetic adjustments.
Okay.
And what we did, you won't see it because it's encased in the flywheel. Mm-hmm. Our engineering team designed it with a magnetic system, which means that it's quiet.
Oh, yeah, it was very quiet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, we're talking over it.
That's right. I never hear a thing.
You never heard a thing.
That's excellent. All right, good. What are some things that people need to consider when looking at equipment?
That's a great question. So the first, and how we designed it, we sort of reverse engineered this product, if you will. And the first thing, Lisa, you mentioned this, is space. Something that we wanted to do is combine 2 fitness equipments, as John mentioned, 2 exercise functions mm-hmm. in a nice, small, neat, effective footprint. Mm-hmm. The next thing you want to look for is safety. So things like treadmills, we understand that they might be easy to get on. It's very common. However, are you still impacting the body with that exercise?
Right.
Because we don't want to create additional injuries. We want to reduce and minimize the risk to the body.
Right. Well, especially for the knees, because I know I'm a runner, and so I do run on treadmill, and the knees take some impact. So how does this help ease that?
Yeah. John, did you want to talk about that?
Well, there's absolutely zero impact.
Okay.
That's the beauty of this. And as a runner, if you're on a treadmill, you're kind of set. Mm-hmm. You put it at 3 miles an hour or 10 miles an hour.
Right.
You have to keep up with the machine.
Mm-hmm.
With this, the machine is a support vehicle for you.
Okay.
You decide, I want to go faster.
Okay.
I want to slow it down.
Okay.
I want to do a stepper now. I want to do an elliptical now. So you're the master of your kingdom with this machine, with a multiple-use machine.
Yeah.
Plus, since it's not programmed at a certain miles per hour or force per hour, you get to decide.
Yeah.
So on Monday, I'm not feeling all that good today.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go a little slower.
Okay.
On Tuesday, I'm energized. I want to put a good workout in.
Okay.
You get to decide. And you can do it during your workout.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So you don't have to change miles per hour or elevation or any of that. As you know, when you're running, get that elevation. That really gets the heart rate going, but it also puts a lot of pressure on your ankles and your knees.
One other point to your great question is when you're looking for fitness equipment, what is your focus? We know at Body Flex Sports, there are a lot of new companies, a lot of new fitness products out that have fancy technology, software technology. What we did is we stayed in our lane and our expertise. We wanted to focus on hardware, literally a function that's going to be good for your physical body.
Okay.
We didn't spend investment on a fancy software monitor. John mentioned it does have the heart rate monitor, very easy to read computer built in this.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it. Simple, easy to use.
Right, and that's important because many times people are overwhelmed by so many instructions or so many things on that they just get frustrated and don't even get on the thing.
Very good.
You have a 12-minute how-to exercise with the product. Does that come with the product?
Yeah, it's accessible from any device.
Okay.
Your tablet, your television, anything that can connect to the internet.
Oh, good.
We do have a 12-minute program designed with a personal trainer.
Okay.
He's also a yoga instructor. Mm-hmm. So he really gets how to use the body and tap into that breath, like John mentioned.
Oh, that's excellent. That's excellent. Any last-minute things you'd like to say?
Well, you had mentioned that you're a runner, run on treadmills, so I'm sure you go to the gym every now and then.
Every now and then, yes.
You get on a machine, and it's intimidating.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You got to put in your weight, your height, your birth date, your social security number, and all this other kind of stuff. And then you get flooded with information.
Mm-hmm.
Just want to work out.
Yep.
You don't need all that stuff.
Right.
So to Yvonne's point, you're not buying a computer. Mm. You're buying an exercise machine.
Right, and the technology.
And the hardware technology, not the software technology.
Excellent. All right. Well, thank you both so much. I love it.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
All right. And remember, if you have any questions about what we just discussed, you can always go to bodyflexsports.com, or you can email info@bodyflexsports.com as well, or call their 888 number as you see on the screen. We'll be right back.
Doctor's number one choice.
I have worked with the doctors at Envision for over 20 years. Their experience, state-of-the-art technology, and positive outcomes have earned them my trust in taking care of our mutual patients.
With clear vision, all things are possible. To schedule your appointment today, contact us at 866-599-2740.
Through my window, I see the first sunlight, and I feel the warm ocean breeze. I see the waves that lulled me all night. That's what my window brings me.
Look at this. That view is $1 million.
It's amazing. We can look at these kinds of places within our budget.
You don't have a bad view from here anywhere you look.
It's all about the view. Sunday night is beach night. Sunday night at 8, only on HGTV.
I got the horses in the back, horse stock is attached. Head is matted black, got the bushes black to match. Riding on a horse, ha, you can whip your Porsche. I've been in the valley, you ain't been up off that porch. Now, can't nobody tell me nothing.
Hi, I'm John Bowser Bauman. You probably know me best as Bowser from Shawnee, but I'm also president of Social Security Works PAC. And you know, when I'm in Laguna Woods, I always watch Village Television. Grease for peace.
Welcome back. What's a pleasure to have Steve Moyer here today. He is the CEO of AgeWell Senior Services. And, you know, we often have people on from the Florence Sylvester, which is fantastic, but they offer a lot, but AgeWell, there's so much more to them than just the Florence Sylvester. Steve, a pleasure.
Likewise.
Yes, it's been really, a while. I think early summer?
Yes.
Last time you were on?
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Let's make 2020 a good one.
Yes, I think we'll do that. Let's talk about, just give us an overview about AgeWell. You know, we have people, new people coming to this community all the time. You know, and they may not have even heard of AgeWell, what you folks do.
Yes, I appreciate that. And first of all, thank you very much for having me on.
Oh, it's a pleasure. It's always fun.
AgeWell Senior Services is a nonprofit organization, and we've been around since 1975. And we operate a variety of things. First of all, we're known for Meals on Wheels. We operate Meals on Wheels in our service area, which is Newport Beach, all the way south to San Clemente. And last year, for example, we served or we delivered 346,000 meals.
That is incredible.
In addition, we operate senior centers. Mm-hmm. And we serve the senior center that we have that serves Laguna Woods is Florence Sylvester, and that's on Moulton Parkway. That's in the DMV shopping center there. And total throughout our organization, we served roughly 76,000 meals, lunches, in our senior centers Monday through Friday.
That's an addition to
to the Meals on Wheels. Also, in our senior center operations, and Florence Sylvester really is our flagship, we not only provide the luncheon service, but we are a wealth of information. We have educational classes, we have health and wellness classes, exercise programs, and we are a resource center. Yeah. And the one thing that I want to express to the Laguna Woods Village residents is please stop by Florence Sylvester and see it, because you will find friends there. You will find it very exciting, a lot of things happening. We've got a lot of new and fresh things happening. For example, on the 15th, we at during lunch period, January 15th, we have this year we had our new registered dietitian there that was providing some information on how to eat healthy, how mm-hmm. to cook healthy for 1 to 2 people. This is something that I think you should get involved with. On January 21st, we have a new entertainer, Tony Rogers, there, and it's going to be a sing-along plus dancing during lunchtime.
All right,
and
I'll be there.
So if you go, and we're serving lunch during that period of time. We have new Tai Chi classes. I think you would enjoy that also.
Yes.
And so a lot of new exciting things that are happening at Florence Sylvester. So please feel free to stop by. Cherie was going to join me today. She's our new site director. So go in, say hello to Cherie, and I think you will find a very, very warm welcome and we being very accommodating.
Yeah, they're great people that are over there. You've had a history of great people over there.
Yes.
And, you know, one of the things that, you know, we've talked about, you and I and Cherie and all, is there's so many different resources over there. There are things that are just fun. They have people coming in that talk about the history of movies, as an example.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have somebody talking about investments, not trying to sell you anything, just kind of give you the lay of the land. You have some that comes in and talks about scams, mm-hmm. Phone scams mm-hmm. and things, health, and just on and on and on. But more than anything else are the resources. And as you know, you've talked about, Cherie has talked about, that you really kind of vet people out. And so if someone goes there and goes, you know what, I'm trying to navigate my way through something, whatever it might be, you guys over there can point them in the right direction.
Absolutely, and that's what we're there for. Again, mm-hmm. we're a nonprofit. We have, our organization gets a little less than 50% from government sources, mm-hmm. and all the rest is private funding.
Right.
The other things that we do is transportation. You've seen our green and white buses throughout the village. We provide non-emergency medical transportation, and we provide nutrition transportation, where we will pick seniors up and take them to the senior center mm-hmm. so they can experience lunch. Last year, we did roughly 65,000 trips that we made. And then we have case management mm-hmm. and in-home services care. So we try to be full service, and anybody who needs help, please feel free to contact our Florence Sylvester location, and we'll do everything that we can to facilitate. The thing that makes our organization so special are 500 volunteers.
Yeah.
And we're always looking for volunteers. If there's ever a situation, somebody out there that would really enjoy volunteering, we really need volunteers at all times. So we operate 9 senior centers. And again, Florence Sylvester is our flagship.
Yeah. In fact, there's one up by me. I live in Rancho Santa Margarita.
The Bell Tower. Yep.
Yeah, and of course the Normandy Murray and all different things. And sometimes there's certain events that are going on over there that we tell people about. But the Florence Sylvester, you know, the main thing I like to tell people is most of the stuff they offer, there's no charge, but you need, there's limited space.
Yes.
So you need to get on a list to call them figure out what you want. There's booklets available that go through the entire month, including menus for the food. Right?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Right.
And the other thing that you've probably seen our commercials. Mm-hmm. We have Vince Ferragamo that has become our company spokesperson. Just a real, real quality guy. Just a really, really neat guy, and was a great football player.
Yeah.
He threw me a spiral the other day, and he's still a good football player. It hurt my hands trying to catch it. But in all sincerity, we have an annual fundraising campaign we do each year. We call this our holiday campaign, and this particular one ends in January. And I ask that in the event that you feel in your heart to make a donation to our organization, it certainly will help us continue to provide the services that we provide. We're a very, very lean organization as far as administratively can, and I think a good nonprofit is, and that's important to us. So. We love seniors. This is our mission, and just trying to do the best that we can. So any help that we can get from any of your watchers, certainly appreciate it.
Yeah, and by the way, you can always do it in a way that you may not even realize you're doing it. Just do smile.amazon.com, and you can pick that organization. That's a great way.
And there's three ways that we have directly. One would be to call us, and you can call Florence Sylvester, or you can call our offices, which are actually in Lake Forest. You can go online, that's myagewell.org, and make a donation there. And then the third way is actually go into Florence, and you can get a particular piece of paper to fill it out and mail it in. So there's three ways to do it.
All right. Okay. We got to run. So thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
We'll get you back a little bit more sooner rather than it's been quite a few months.
And I saw you a little bit earlier today on TV, and you had a variety of hats on, and I liked each and every one.
All right. So, thank you very much.
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you.
We'll be back.
I retired 18 years ago, and a good friend of mine says, "Hey, Gear, what the hell are you going to do with your time now?" And the next thing I knew, I was a delivery man for Meals on Wheels.
To the homebound neighbors he's delivered meals to for 18 years, my father, Homer Gear, is the real leading man.
Hey, well, hello there. How are you today?
This is how we burger brew and cue. Pick a town. Arrive hungry, real hungry. Start with a massive burger. Charred, juicy, add bacon, a buttery bun, piled high. Serve it up, wash it down. Creamy, hoppy, fruity, malty. We're not done yet. Q-time, deep fried, sauce soaked, pork ribs, meaty, tender. I'm full. Where to next?
All new Burgers Brew and Q. Tuesday at 9. Cooking Channel. Stay fired up.
Ready or not, baby.
Mom and I take on some of the nastiest places in our neighborhood.
If the home has good bones, we'll turn them into amazing spaces.
Ready or not.
And we're just getting started.
Get out of my way, boys.
Oh, my God.
Ta-da!
Wow! It's gorgeous.
Go ahead, toot your own horn.
Toot, toot.
All new Good Bones, Tuesday at 9 on HGTV.
I'm Dr. Leif Loberg, and I want to welcome you to our brand new facility here in Laguna Woods. We've been serving the community since 2006, and we're super excited to bring you an awesome team of doctors, Dr. Jackson, Dr. Ossaturians, Dr. Vian, myself, here to serve you in our brand new state-of-the-art facility. Call us in the morning, and we'll get you in the same day, guaranteed.
This one is going to be a challenge for me.
Everything's moving 100 miles an hour.
This is your worst nightmare. Get out!
Please, bring you this forward.
MasterChef. Wednesdays or watch anytime on demand or Fox Now.
Welcome back. Well, we have Alan Feldman on here, and he is with the Democratic Club. And, you know, they put up a show on our program. I think, one's coming up in February. Just taped it.
Well, yes, we did, yes.
Yeah, so it's not every month, but it's, you know, maybe
three or four times a
year. When appropriate. There you go.
When we have something to say.
All right. Alan's always got something to say.
That's for
sure.
The
first thing you have something to say about is that, of course, the presidential primary, or just the primary elections in general, you know, in this state, have been moved up to March 3rd.
That's right. It's historically, yeah. It's been in June.
Yeah,
So now it's March 3rd, so that's the best six weeks, and it's really moving up on people much more quickly than
yeah.
they anticipate.
I remember years ago they talked about that, and I don't know what it takes to move a primary. I don't, if it's state or
it's
federal.
It's a state law.
It is a state, yeah. but yeah. didn't they try that like years ago?
I don't know if they tried it here or not, but I know they wanted action in the presidential primaries.
Yeah.
And by June, the race has been decided.
Quite often,
yeah,
yes.
So they moved it to March. So, you know, as a result, I'll move right into
okay, yeah, because you're having an event coming up.
That's right. We do this.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. We do this every election.
Yes, you do.
Twice, once before the primary, once before the mm-hmm. general election. We invite all the candidates we can accommodate.
Right.
Who are running for office in our local area, and get them to come down to Laguna Woods so they can speak directly
yeah.
to the voters here in Laguna Woods. And we have two meetings scheduled, actually within a week. The first mm-hmm. one is going to be on Sunday, January 19th, 2 p.m. at the Towers.
Yes.
Uh-huh. And the next one is going to be on Tuesday, January 21st, 7 p.m. at Clubhouse 2.
Okay.
That's
now-
all. Regular meeting.
Different candidates each time?
Well,
or
no,
just
we've invited the same candidates, and
okay.
We actually have acceptances. Our member of Congress, Katie Porter, member
okay.
of Congress from the 45th District, is going to be there. Our member from the California State Assembly, Connie Petrie Norris, from the 74th District, she is going to be there also. And she's accepted. And we also have two candidates, two good Democrats running for a state Senate, Dave Min, who ran for office in 2018, spends a lot of time
yeah,
in Laguna Woods.
I,
he is well known here.
I recognize
yeah.
him, the name, yeah.
He's mm-hmm. running for state Senate. And another Democrat, Katrina Foley, now she's not as well known in Laguna Woods. She's the mayor of Costa Mesa.
They're
both running. So we really feel it's two good Democrats and running for this office. And we're also, we're going to play a little inside baseball. There's a race inside the Democratic Party that's
yeah,
going on.
Yeah.
It's for what's called the Democratic Party of Orange County Central Committee. It's mm-hmm. kind of the board of directors
right.
Of the Democratic Party. And two village residents and Democratic Club members, Jonathan Adler and Janice Burstyn, they currently serve on the board, and they're running for re-election.
Right.
And
that's what your show is in February.
That's what we speak with Janice and Jonathan.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But we've invited all the candidates running for Central Committee, and we hope they don't show up because there's 17 of them, and that accounts for
yeah.
a lot of those names. And we really think this is a big thing, an important thing for people. Give our residents an opportunity to see and hear these candidates
yeah.
in person, you know, and get an opportunity to kind of size them up, see what they're like. And of course, the candidates always want to speak to voters.
Right.
And it's an important thing. And I'll tell you what, it's really important for more even than Katie Porter and Connie Petrie Norris. People know who they are. But in what we call down ballot elections.
You know, you're right about that. And you and I have talked about this. And it doesn't matter which party you're in. The down ballot, as you call it,
yeah.
Often gets overlooked, especially during a presidential primary.
Well, exactly.
Sometimes I think that, you know, you almost need a different election just for these other things, because people just like, we don't know who these people are. And it, you know, it's sad in a way. I don't care, again, what party you're in.
Right.
A lot of people just overlook. They're like, well, okay, we'll just, we like their name. We'll vote for that.
A lot of people just skip over those
yeah,
elections
yeah.
because they don't know enough mm-hmm. about the candidates. It's so hard for these candidates
yes.
to generate interest, to get themselves heard, get their message out.
Right,
they don't have the resources the other candidates do. And yet, they sit now in the presidential year. There's not that many.
Right.
In the off years, what they call the off year elections, 2018, 2020. There's all these local, regional, countywide agencies and boards, and they're so important. They make lifestyle decisions. Mm-hmm. They make decisions about water quality and electricity and transportation.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you one thing, just one thing about that, how important this can be. We had a village resident, Mike Gaskins.
Yeah, I know Mike.
In 2018, because of his education experience, he decided he wanted to run for the El Toro Water District Board of Directors. And he won. First office he's ever run for in his life. And he, I know, because he's told us, he feels that the reason he won that election is because of the exposure, the platform that the Laguna Woods Democratic Club was was able to bring to
him. Yeah, so, we've had him on a few times. Hey, we just got a minute left.
Yeah.
We want to quickly tell people that, we're going to have on next week, we have Lisa Bartlett on, of course, the supervisor for this district. She's going to bring on Neil Kelly, who is, what's the official title?
Registrar of Voters.
Okay. And, of course, there's different ways of voting this year, about all the ballots are mailed out.
Right. Everybody.
So we're going to get into that with him next week.
Okay.
Yeah.
Say one thing, but I don't know how much time we have left. But
got like half 30 seconds.
Okay, you don't have to be a Democrat to vote in the Democratic primary.
Right.
If you are a non-party preference voter, and they call in California, what we used to call independents, not registered in any party, you can receive a Democratic primary ballot. You can ask the Registrar of Voters office for it. They sent out a postcard a couple of weeks ago saying, what do you want? What kind of ballot do you want? Fill it out, say, I want a Democratic ballot. They'll send you one. Call the office. Go on their website. Democratic Party wants everybody to vote in their primary. So it's easy to get a Democratic ballot if you are a non-party preference voter. If you're a member of another party, forget it. You can't vote.
Yeah, and they changed it to non-party because there really is an independent
party. That's right.
I was like, what was that all about? I'm an independent, but I'm part of a party. Anyway, Alan,
thank you
good
so much,
to see
Ken.
You.
Great to see you, as always.
And Democratic Club, that'll be on next month. We got a set the times for that, but you'll find out really about the Democratic Central Committee and the candidates for that. We'll be right back.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, that was all.
Welcome back. I'm Kiana Lee. Today, we're talking to Dr. Chuck Lee of 7-Day Dental. Today's topic is teeth whitening. Doctor, what do we need to know about teeth whitening? Dad.
Oh, the whitening kit whitens teeth up to 5 shades in 10 minutes, and it's zero sensitivity.
Thank you, doctor. So come on in and get your 7-Day Dental smile.
Our Friday movie is called Lord of War. It was from 2005, and it is about a 20-year arms-dealing career of Queens, New York outcast Yuri Orlov, who is played by Nicolas Cage, serves as a window into the end of the Cold War and the emergence of worldwide terrorism. He finds himself reassuring his more ethically challenged younger brother, Vitaly, played by Jared Leto, while adeptly sidestepping the pursuit of federal agent Jack Lawrence, who's played by Ethan Hawke. The globe-trotting arms dealer also pursues the women of his dreams, or the woman of his dreams, supermodel Ava Fontaine, who's played by Bridget Moynihan. Interesting,
yeah.
Interesting. Okay, so I already told you who was starring in it, and this will be action, crime, and drama, and that will be on Friday, January 17th, and that's usually at 2 and 6 p.m.?
No, 7.
7 p.m.
2 and 7.
2 and 7.
Yeah, that's an interesting movie.
Yeah, it's very interesting. Like it. And that is brought to you by Escrow Options.
All right. Now, I forgot my hats. I left them outside there.
There were several hats.
I had several hats. Yes, I did. I am going to tell you about the weather. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I was telling you about the rain coming in. And the window has shortened. So we'll see how much rain we'll get. And right now, looks like that window of opportunity is going to be about 10 o'clock tomorrow night, Thursday, to maybe about 2 or 3 in the morning on Friday. And then it's going to clear right up. So maybe a quarter inch, maybe a half inch out of this, we'll see, and we can certainly use it. And then look at Sunday, and going on Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday, we're all going to be in the 70s. So there you are. And around the county today, very similar to what we had yesterday. So pretty nice weather throughout Southern California today. And there we go. Got my hats back. There we are. There's the weather. And Big Bear up. It's kind of warm up there today, 53 degrees, you know?
Yeah.
Not bad at all. They will get snow tomorrow, by the way.
Oh.
Yeah. Not a whole lot, but they are expected to get maybe 6 inches of snow or something. So all those temperatures are going to really dive down there tomorrow. So there you go. We got our hats back.
Our hats back.
I'm trying to figure out which one.
Oh, they're not going to.
Maker's Mark. Yeah, so am
Maker's I. Mark, yeah.
Yes, this is one of my barbecue ones, of course. I got to have a Mickey hat.
Did you even
Nashville?
Notice that he was changing all of his hats? So go back and watch our 12:30, and he changed his hats
yes.
the whole time.
Yeah, I got a lot of hats. That's for darn sure.
You do. All right. Well, tomorrow we have a full show.
Yeah,
Who
we
is going to be on our show tomorrow? It is going to be Memorial Care, Thrive, mm-hmm. Social Services, and we have the Globe headlines. So have a great day in the village. We'll see you tomorrow.
Yep. Do-do-do.